Okay, coming up next, we're going on a goose hunt with Ray Sidorchik.
Nothing adds to the hunting experience like a good friend and the use of a side-by-side ATV. I find that we have more time to talk about our hunting strategies and just enjoy the day much more. Let's take a look at a typical day's hunt using the Kawasaki 3010 Mule.
The 3010 Mule is a great unit for transporting the personnel and gear needed for a day in the field. We find the unit to be built well with the same transportation capability of an old Willys Jeep. The vehicle is powered by a quiet 617cc V-twin industrial engine, which produces steady, easy-to-use power. The Mule uses a CVT automatic transmission that provides high and low drive ranges. The drivetrain is completed with a drive shaft-driven front and rear differential. The rear differential has a lever that can be engaged to produce a positive rear drive, allowing the rear wheel drive to use both rear wheels for traction. Now, if that's not enough, the front differential can be engaged to produce a four-wheel drive mode. This maximum traction capability enables the Mule to crawl around in very slippery conditions, such as snow or mud. Today's hunt is an early season goose hunt here in the Northeast. We use the Mule to travel back on wooded trails that lead to a secluded beaver pond. The unit allows us to pack in all the gear needed, such as our weapons, decoys, and a chocolate lab retriever. As we drive along on the trails, we're able to talk over what has happened on prior hunts and what our plans will be for that day.
Well, we're in the early season of goose here in Pennsylvania, and this past Monday was the first day. Yes, last night we were out, and we spotted a flock of maybe 60 or more come down.
Yeah, possibly more. I would say maybe closer to 100.
The problem with the early season goose hunting is they don't really respond to the calls or the setup. They're not under any pressure. They're in their groups of the young birds, right? And they just kind of come down in and they plop down wherever, right?
Yeah, they have a specific element which it's pretty neat because you can follow them day to day. They're usually feeding in the same, I would say, 2 to 3 fields, roosting, similar to a turkey in the same farm pond or swamp or lake. In our case, it's going to be a flooded timber swamp. With the recent rain, the swamp is quite high.
Right. And I would think that, scouting is really where it's at for this.
Oh, absolutely.
If you know where the birds are, you can set up on them, and it increases your chances of a sure, at least a few shots, right?
Right.
After reaching our desired location, we walk a short distance across some flooded fields and into our goose blind. Now all we need to do is wait and hope for a flock to drop into range. Waterfowl hunting is more a social event than most hunting situations. What I mean is you can talk and have plenty of fun while waiting for the birds to come in. But once the birds have been spotted, then the hunt becomes very serious. It takes a lot of work to bring the birds into gun range. As with any sport, if it was easy, then no one would be interested. Luckily, we have a team member who lives and breeds waterfowl. Bill brings his knowledge of flight and his experience to the table.
It's getting about that time, huh, Bill?
Yeah, I'll tell you what's very interesting about this season is there's a fine line between when the geese are going to come in to roost and when your shooting deadlines are.
Right.
I think last night we had it by about 20 minutes. But it's going to be real important, especially with this overcast day, to properly identify everything that's going to happen.
Right.
I'm anticipating they're going to come from this way. This is where we've been patterning them. There's some big cornfields about a half a mile that way that actually a farmer just cut. So I'm guessing there's some fresh food in there.
As the day progressed, we did have a few shots. The action was fast and furious for a short time. As it turns out, the geese were flying high and they needed a little coaxing to come in. Just watching the bird circle makes the adrenaline flow. We saw flock after flock that day, but only a few would come within range. The day's expectations were met and everyone had a great time, even our dog Chelsea, who waited patiently for a bird to retrieve. After a few hours of hunting, we decided to call it a day and began our trip back with help from the Mule. Unless you have had experience and the convenience of loading all your gear into a side-by-side utility unit and driving out from a remote location, you may not realize what a great asset these vehicles are.
Do you enjoy spending time hunting with your family and friends? If you're anything like me, you do. I really look forward to getting away for an afternoon of riding and hunting. I'm not sure which one I enjoy more, but one thing is for sure, I love taking the time to enjoy the outdoor experience.